Okay, my dear students, so in the previous video you understood that how single displacement reactions undergo. Okay, so and I asked you a very interesting question and a very conceptual question as well, that when we add copper and zinc sulfate to each other, no reaction will take place. Why? Because copper is less reactive than zinc, so it is not going to displace it. Okay, now let us have some reactions, single displacement reactions based on the non-metallic reactivity series of halogens. Okay, so I am writing a simple reaction in front of you. Hi plus Cl2. So you can see that the reaction will be HCl plus I2. Now the equation is balanced. Okay, so you can see that we have the non-metals like iodine and chlorine, and if you know the non-metal, yani the reactivity series of halogens, fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, and I said to you that if you go upwards the reactivity increases and if we go downwards the reactivity decreases. Okay, so chlorine is more reactive than iodine, isn't it? Chlorine is more reactive than the iodine. That is why chlorine is displacing iodine, as you can see in the product side. Chlorine is displacing iodine. So these are some examples of single displacement reactions. Now let us try to have a look at the final one, that is the double displacement reaction. Okay, double displacement reaction. So these two types, the previous one that is single displacement reaction and the double displacement reaction, are the important ones, because the other ones are easy, quite easy to understand. Combination and decomposition, displacement and double displacement, you will be when you will be learning the reactions, you will be facing these types of reactions more often, that is single displacement and double displacement. That is why you have to put extra focus on these two types. Okay, double displacement reaction is like this: A B plus C D is equals to A C plus B D. Okay, so my dear students, you can see that the basic structure of double displacement reaction is this one. B and C double displacement reaction is this, that is A and D will combine with each other and you will have A and D, and you can see that B and C are combining with each other, so you will have B and C. Okay, so this is the correct combination. The previous one was incorrect by mistake I did. Okay, so this is the correct combination. So the side entities are combining and they are forming a product, and the middle entities are combining and they are forming a product. So this is how double displacement reaction takes place. A question arises that do we have to apply the reactivity series in this type of reactions? No, you don't have to apply. Just follow this simple technique. That is, the last entities will combine and they form a new product, and the middle ones they combine and form a new product.